Hello!
全ては偶然だ。だがその偶然はあらかじめ決められていた世界の意志でもあった。俺はイカれてなどいない。至って正常だ。ここでは真実を語っているんであって、断じて中二病の妄想なんかじゃない。きっかけはほんの些細なことだとしても、それが未来の大きな流れを決定づけてしまうこともある。バタフライ効果という言葉を知っているか。知らないなら調べるのだ。それぐらいの慎重さが求められているのだということを理解しろ。残念ながら俺は慎重じゃなかった。自分の愚かさを分かっていた。あいつを失うことになんてならなかった。未来をこんな形にしてしまうなんてこともなかった。分かるはずがないだろう。その瞬間の自分の手に人類全ての運命を決定づけるような重大なターニングポイントのスイッチが握られているなんていうことは分かるはずがないのだ。考えてもみるがいい。普段の人間の知覚は 99% が遮断されている。人は自分で思っている以上に愚鈍な生き物なんだよ。普段の生活の中に埋もれている何気ないことなど気にも留めないし、知覚したとしてもすぐに忘れるか、脳が処理をしないかのどちらかなんだ。あの時の俺に言ってやりたい。迂闊なことをするなと、軽率なことをするなと、見て見ぬふりをするなと、もっと注意を払えと。陰謀の魔の手は思った以上にずっと短いなんて。いつでもお前を陥れようと手ぐすね引いているのだと。
Wow, okay.
宇宙の始まりはあるか、終わりはない。無限。星にもまた始まりはあるが、自らの力を持って滅びゆく。有限。英知を持つ者こそ最も愚かである。歴史からも読み取れる。海に行ける魚は陸の世界を知らない。彼らが英知を持てば、それもまた滅びゆく。人間が光の速さを超えるのは、魚たちが陸で生活を始めるよりも滑稽。これは抗える者たちに対する神からの最後通告となる。
Okay, I didn't expect that when you heard just the piano music at the beginning of the game, and it felt a little bit like it's going to be a lot of...A lot of romance already in the beginning, but that was something else. Hey, what are you mumbling about? There's no sound from the phone against my right ear. I'm in silence. I'm baking in the summer sun. Sweat slowly slides down my chin and drips onto the asphalt.
Opari, yes, go.
Ocarine Earth to Ocarine. A girl is standing in front of me. She calls my name with an inquisitive tilt of her head. We are about to infiltrate deep into the enemy's territory. Yet despite the imminent risk of death, there is no hint of tension on her innocent, childlike features. It doesn't feel like we're going to an enemy territory. I mean, feels like we're just out shopping or something. I cover my phone's mouthpiece and turn to the girl with an index finger to my lips. Talking to someone? I nod and put my phone back to my ear. Still no sound from the other side. My contact is wise to maintain silence. The whole area.Be bugged.
Yeah, こちらの話だ。
No, I was just talking to someone.
これより会場に潜入する。
Everything's fine. I'm about to infiltrate the assembly hall. Still no reply. Looks like they just want my report. It's too dangerous to waste time talking here anyway. Yeah, Dr. Nakabashi got the jump on us, but I'll make sure to tell us everything. What? The organization is already on the move? I open my eyes wide to match my shocked tone. The girl turns towards me in surprise. I sigh, shaking my head as I rub my temples. I see. So that's the choice of Steins Gate, Elfsai Kongro. I speak the parting words, then pocket my cell phone. Steins Gate. Some know it as fate. To others, it is the will of God. Do you count on one hand the people in this world are aware of its true nature? In any case, we should begin the infiltration. I advance towards Radican, which is just across the street from the train station. Of course, this is enemy territory. I can't just stride through the front door like an average person. Enemies, like it feels like we're not really in a war zone, you know? I bypass the elevators and escalators and head to the 8th floor by the stairwell. But I only make it to the 7th floor before I have to stop and rest. And rest, wow! Who was that on the phone? The girl, Shina Mayuri, immediately resumes our conversation. She followed me all the way here, and she isn't even short of breath. I, on the other hand, am gasping for air with my hands on my knees. Who would have thought an 8-story building would be so tall? I turned to Mayuri while wiping the sweat off my brow. If I told you, I'd had to kill you. Well, that. Oh wow, thanks, Okarin. What the hell is going on here? Mayuri smiles happily and doesn't pry any further. As always, she is quick to understand my position. We've known each other since we were both little. Mayuri is 16, 2 years younger than me, so she's more like a little sister than a typical childhood friend. I've been looking out for her as long as I can remember. I used to hope that Mayuri might become the key to Steins Gate, but now I reconsider. I don't want that terrible fate for her. She should live a normal life. That is my present wish. We continue to the 8th floor and enter the assembly hall. In front of us stands a cheap-looking stage with a podium and sign reading Dr. Nakabashi's Time Machine Press Conference. Okarin. Mayuri insists on calling me Okarin. But it's neither my real name nor my code name. It's just one of those annoying nicknames people use.
Mayuri yo.
How many times do I have to tell you? Don't call me Okarin. Huh? But I've always called you that.
それは昔の話だ。今の俺は法院教魔。世界中の秘密組織から狙われる狂気のマッドサイエンティストだ。
That was then. I have since become Hoyo. God damn it. Hoyoin Kiyuma. The insane mad scientist hunted by secret organizations the world over. Mwahaha.
Because it's difficult to
But that's too hard to remember.
Yeah, it is. In any case,
Hoyoin Kuyoma is my true name.
Oh.
And besides, it doesn't even sound like Okabe Rintaro. You're weird. Cease your foolish laughter. Akabe Rintaro may be my real name, but I have rejected it, for it is stupid. And so, I also hate the derivative Okari. Come on, it sounds like that elf boy's blue pipe thing. So, Ocarine, can I ask you something? In one ear and out of the other. She's been calling me that for 5 years now, so maybe it's time to give up.
Yeah.
What are we doing here? Yeah, that is something that I want to ask you too. Or probably we, because I don't understand. Wait, you follow me here without knowing why? Yep. She nods without dropping her smile. We're here for Dr. Nakabashi's press conference. We're standing in the assembly hall on the 8th floor of Radican. It is here that the conference will be held. Dr. Nakabashi is an inventor. He appears on TV from time to time and has a few patents under his belt. But mostly he is treated as a curiosity. Press conference? But where are the reporters? Ayuri's right. I've scanned the entire hall, but there's no one who looks like a reputable reporter or cameraman. There are only about 10 of us standing in the hall, including me. Oh, so there are actually more people here. There is not just an empty hall. Considering Nakabashi's moderate media presence and the fact that he claims to have invented a time machine, we'd have expected more. Could this be the organization working its twisted influence? I twist my lips into a sneer. I thought that Nakabashi was like me, a scientist fighting to overthrow the organization. An organization? Is it like a organization that is trying to prevent other people to do whatever they want, or? But this press conference suggests other motives at work. Our enemies won't miss this chance. I prefer not to get wrapped up in his mess. Nevertheless, I am interested in what he has to say. That's why I'm here, blowing an afternoon off my precious summer holiday. Mayuri ponders by utterance for a while before finally turning her head. You wrapped something? Is it his birthday too? I let out a sigh. Mayuri is known to not only make bad jokes, but to laugh at them too. She's always been special. Yeah, I understand. Keep your guard up, Mayuri. I suspect this won't be a normal confer. I didn't even finish my sentence. Are we under attack? Are they trying to fry our brains with electromagnetic waves?